CNN's Acosta Cries press isn't America's enemy, Sarah torches him with flamethrower. CNN's Jim Acosta is the biggest hack who is constantly making himself the story. That's what happened as he pressed Sarah Huckabee Sanders hard to take back President Donald Trump's claim that the press is the enemy of the American people. The White House press secretary wasn't playing his game, as she torched Acosta with a flamethrower. Don't miss this. CNN's Jim Acosta attempted to take over the White House press briefing on Thursday, but he was sorely outsmarted by our brilliant press secretary, Sarah Sanders. The latest leftist narrative is that President Trump and his supporters are dangerous and that the president has somehow committed a grave sin by saying the press is the enemy of the American people. Acosta was reeling after being humiliated at the recent Trump rally in Florida, where the CNN hack found himself unable to report back to Wolf Blitzer as the Trump supporters were screaming CNN sucks so loud that he couldn't hear himself talk. So, Acosta was going to make Sanders take back that he is America's enemy. Fox News reports, White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders used her nationally televised press briefing Thursday to say some very important things about the round-the-clock and relentless criticism of the president and his team coming from the Trump-hating mainstream media. They add, while journalists have focused much attention on President Trump's criticism of media bias and fake news, along with his description of many in the media as enemies of the people, they focus far less attention on their own blatant bias against the president. As CNN's famously anti-Trump correspondent Acosta demanded, she acknowledges that saying the press is the enemy of the American people is dangerous and wrong as he played his victim card. Sarah torched him with a flamethrower. Sanders said, "It's ironic, Jim, that not only you and the media attack the president for his rhetoric when they frequently lower the level of conversation in this country. Repeatedly the media resorts to personal attacks without any content other than to incite anger." Sanders continued to burn Acosta, "Repeatedly, the media has attacked me personally, on a number of occasions including your own network. Said I should be harassed as a life sentence. That I should be choked. ICE officials are not welcome in their place of worship and personal information is shared on the internet. When I was hosted by the Correspondents Association, of which almost all of you are members of, you brought a comedian up to attack my appearance and call me a traitor to my own gender. In fact, as far as I know, I'm the first press secretary in the history of the United States that required Secret Service protection," Sarah blasted at Acosta, as he sat there looking like a buffoon. Acosta took to Twitter immediately after he got cooked at the presser, and he wrote a Dear Diary entry that sounds like a whining baby. "I walked out of the end of that briefing because I am totally saddened by what just happened." Sarah Sanders was repeatedly given a chance to say the press is not the enemy and she wouldn't do it. "Shameful," posted Crybaby Acosta. What's Acosta's problem with Sarah Sanders telling the truth? Seems he can't handle the truth. Well, Sarah also humiliated Acosta and his cohorts on Twitter, boasting, "Trump derangement syndrome is becoming a major epidemic among Democrats. Instead of freaking out about the booming Trump economy, why not celebrate it?" God bless Sarah Sanders. She is battling these leftist losers daily, on behalf of the president and on behalf of the American people. Imagine a world where the only news we could get was from hacks like Jim Acosta. We would never hear how far Trump has already gone in making America great again. America has made a comeback, and nothing's